Hello everyone, welcome to SemiKanto. Today's topic is kappa Y bonding. Let's talk about it. Kappa Y bonding is a Y bonding technology to use kappa instead of gold. Compared to gold, kappa Y bonding has better electrical conductivity, better thermal conductivity, better reliability with slower intermetallic growth. It also has some drawbacks. Kappa is easy to be oxidized, and it can degrade reliability and integrity of wire bonding. Kappa is harder than gold, so it can also damage bond pad and underlying circuitry during wire bonding process. So, bonding parameters must be kept under tight control to prevent these issues. Why people think about kappa wire bonding, even though we already have gold wire bonding? Because gold is very expensive and its price is skyrocketing. This is material price comparison among popular wire materials: gold, copper, silver, and aluminum. Usually, gold price is based on ounce, and 1 ounce is 28.34 grams. But to compare gold price to others, I calculated based on kilograms. So, in here, gold is $62,435 per kilogram. Copper price is based on ton, probably because its price is low. So, per kilogram, copper is $6. As you can see in the graph at the bottom, copper is way more cheaper than gold, and that is the main reason to use copper instead of gold. If you want to check more accurate price for these materials, please check London Metal Exchange. Typically, copper wire is 3 to 10 times cheaper than gold wire. Here are more details of its advantages. And this is comparison of electrical conductivity and thermal conductivity between gold and copper. Copper has better electrical conductivity about 41% than gold, and better thermal conductivity about 32% than gold. This is comparison of intermetallic compound between gold and copper. As you can see in the photo, copper wire has less intermetallic compound than gold wire, so copper wire has better reliability performance. This is how copper wire looks like. Available wire diameters are from 0.6 mm to 4 mm. 1 mm is 25.4 micrometers. Palladium-coated copper wire is a common alternative. It has better corrosion resistance than pure copper with higher price, but still lower price than gold. Available palladium-coated copper wire diameters are from 0.6 mm to 2 mm. Another wire is gold flash palladium coated copper wire, and it has wider second bond process window than palladium coated copper wire. Available wire diameters are from 0.2 mm to 2 mm. Copper wire bonding machine and tool look like this. It uses foaming gas during the formation of copper free elbow to prevent copper oxidation. And foaming gas is mixture of 95% nitrogen gas and 5% hydrogen gas. Here is process flow of copper wire bonding. And it is very similar with gold wire bonding, except foaming gas. Step 1, wire feed into capillary from wire spool. Step 2, EFO spark. EFO stands for electric flame. It is to make electric spark, then melt wire. Step 3, free ball formation. Among these steps, step 2 and 3 are critical compared to gold wire bonding. And copper wire bonding uses foaming gas to prevent copper oxidation during formation of copper free elbow. And this foaming gas wall should be sufficient to make good inert atmosphere. Copper oxidation during ball formation inhibits the formation of spherical ball, then degrade the reliability performance of first ball bond. So, copper oxidation must be avoided to make a symmetric free elbow without ball size deviation. Step 4, first bond. Critical process parameters are bonding pulse, ultrasonic energy, heat from heater block, bonding time. Step 5, wire looping to read finger. Step 6, second bond. Critical process parameters are ultrasonic energy, bonding pulse, bonding time, probe. Step 7, clamp wire and tears wire, leaving wire tail for next bonding. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye bye.